Bonjour et bienvenue pour ce chapitre 2. Chapitre 2. And we start straight away by introducing the topics of chapter 2. Alors, nous allons apprendre, we are going to learn to be, to have in French, the physical description personality, to do, to go, faire, aller, which are two verbs irregular, ER and IR verbs, verbes en ER et IR. Nous parlerons, we're going to speak about hobbies, sports, clothes, and how to make any kind of questions in French. So the chapter 2 is very interesting and I hope you will enjoy it. We start straight away. Le verbe être is to be in English. Let's read together the sentences. We start on the top left. Je suis positif. You can try to already think about what does it mean. Tu es joyeux. Il est nerveux. Elle est stressée. Okay, so maybe you have an idea of what it means. Look at the drawings. And I'm pretty sure you can already know, you already know what the sentences mean. I am positive. You are happy. He is nervous and she is stressed. On continue, we continue. Vous êtes nerveux. Nous sommes riches. Ils sont contents. Elles sont nerveuses. Okay, so here we have vous êtes nerveux. Vous is like you plural in English. You plural, many, many, many persons, more than one. Vous êtes nerveux. It can be used for one person as well, because remember in chapter one we said if you use vous, it's when you want to be formal, very polite, and you will have to use this vous. So vous can be used for two things. Formal conversation with one person, or like you plural in English, like you people. Vous êtes nerveux. Just exactly like in this example. Nous sommes riches. We are rich. Ils, with S, sont contents. You see, you can see it's different from English here. Ils sont contents. Elles sont nerveuses. All right. So, il with S is like they for plural masculine version. In Espanol, ellos. So, il, it's they for boys, men, masculine. Elle with S is they for female version. As you can see in the photo. Elles sont nerveuses. They are nervous. And if I say elles sont nerveuses, it's a group of girls. More than one at least. In Espanol, ellas. So if you speak Spanish, you can understand the distinction very well. If you speak English, it's not like in English where they have only they. Here we have il for more than one boy and elle for more than one girl. So be careful and be aware of this. Okay, just to summarize, je suis, tu es, il, elle est, I am, you are, he is, she is. Vous êtes, you are, plural or formal. Nous sommes, we are. Ils sont, elles sont. And here you have your verb être in French. Le verbe être en français. So now your job is to complete these sentences with le verbe être en français. Maybe you don't remember, it's okay. You can go back in the video and take notes in your notebook and try with your memory already to then come back to this page and complete the sentences. Okay, So now I'm going to give you the answers. Je suis riche. And you know what it means. Nous sommes en France pour 15 jours. Vous êtes professeur de français? Elle est blonde. Tu es sympathique. Elles sont roumaines. Il est policier à Paris. Now I'm going to translate for you the sentences. I am rich. We are in France for 15 days. You are a French teacher. She's blonde. You are sympathetic, nice. They are Romanians. He is policeman in Paris. And here you know le verbe être. It's not rocket science. There is nothing much to do. The thing is to memorize them. It's a question of memorization. And try to write some sentences about you or someone else with être. What can you say with être in French? Quelle est ta nationalité? Je suis espagnol. Je suis russe. Tu es intelligent? You are intelligent, etc., etc. You can try to write two or three sentences in your notebook to practice être. Just very simple sentences with what we already previously learned together. Okay, so we learned être, to be, and now we want to learn have, avoir, to have, avoir. Let's read together and listen carefully. J'ai un chien qui s'appelle Toby. You can see in the photo, in the drawing on the right side. Tu as une sœur qui habite en France. Il a trois livres. Nous avons une table dans ce bar. Vous avez des bananes. Ils ont une Ferrari. Elles ont de la chance. OK? So, have, like in English, is something you own, something you possess, but also can be feelings, like being cold, being lucky, etc. Alors, your job now is to write down in your notebook le verbe avoir. Just copy it in your notebook. You can copy the examples or just what's in yellow in this page. J'ai, tu as, il a, elle a, nous avons, vous avez, ils ont, elles ont. And then you know it's I have, you have, he has, we have, you have, etc. They have, etc., etc. Avoir, something you own, you possess, or feelings. Same story. Now try to practice. How would you say I have a Japanese friend? We have some tickets for the concert, etc., etc. You can pause the video, take your time, and complete those sentences in your notebook or just out loud at home. Right. And now I'm going to give you the answers. Let's compare with what you wrote. J'ai un ami japonais. I have a Japanese friend. Nous avons, you see the liaison when we speak, nous avons, we don't say nous avons, even though it's fine to say nous avons, it's better to say nous avons, des billets pour le concert. Vous avez une table IKEA? C'est like a question. Do you have an IKEA table? Elle a quatre frères. You know what it means, because we studied this chapter of family. Tu as un ballon pour jouer au foot? Elles ont un examen de français dans 1 heure. Il a un père mécanicien à Lyon, en France. He has a father, mechanic father in Lyon, in France. Now, the good idea is to try to see if you understand those sentences. I will translate for you and then see if it match with what you thought. I have a Japanese friend. We have some tickets for the concert. You have an IKEA table. She has four brothers. You have a ball to play football. They have a French exam in 1 hour, and he has a mechanic Father in Lyon in France. Voilà. Donc le verbe être et le verbe avoir. Should not have any secrets for you. Of course, you can watch the video again and take notes and practice and practice and practice. It's a question of memorization here. Nothing else. Here is a little overview that you could copy in your notebook. It's a main overview of what we just said. You can pause the video, look at it, take notes, do whatever you want with it. Okay, and now this is a challenging part of être et avoir. You have to choose. Complète les phrases avec être ou avoir. You have to choose être ou avoir and then conjugate. So it's not super easy. It's a very good practice. All right. So let's see together. Elle, blah, 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 Colombienne. They want to say they are Colombians. We say in French, elle, with être, sont Colombienne. Elles sont colombiennes. And you can see here, the verb être, elles sont. Elles sont colombiennes. OK, good. Nous, blah, 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 un lama qui s'appelle Paul. We have. How do you say we have in French? Nous avons un lama qui s'appelle Paul. I am curious. Je suis curieux. You have. In French, we say you have 40 years old. We don't say you are. We say you have. And you have is tu as. Tu as 40 ans. She's nice, sympathetic. Elle est sympathique. Look here. Elle est sympathique. Verbe être. Il, plural, they, male. Il, blablabla, bla, bla, deux sœurs et trois frères. C'est une grande famille. Ils ont, avoir, ils ont une grande famille. Ils ont une grande famille, with perfect pronunciation. Vous, blablabla, bla, bla, des chiens ou des chats. Ou means or. Vous avez des chiens ou des chats? Et I have... Tab IKEA. I don't know why this example is always there, but maybe I love IKEA, I don't know. J'ai une table IKEA, which is I have an IKEA table. J'ai une table IKEA. So, how was it? Difficult? Easy? Hard? It's just a question of memorization. More you practice, better you will remember, of course. And now what I would like you to do is to, here is a correction if you want to check, of course. What I would like you to do now in your head or in your notebook or out loud is to make like four sentences with être and four sentences with avoir. Quatre phrases avec être, quatre phrases avec avoir. In your notebook, in your head, in your out loud, et no problem. For example, if you have no idea, I will ask you a couple of questions. As-tu un chien? As-tu un chien? You see here, as-tu un chien? Oui, j'ai un chien. Ou non, je n'ai pas de chien. Remember the negation? We studied in chapter 1. Another question for you. Es-tu sympathique? Oui, je suis sympathique. Ou bien non, je ne suis pas sympathique. Es-tu français? Non, attends, alors, let me change. Êtes-vous français? Let's imagine. Êtes-vous français? I'm asking to a group of people. Hey, you guys, êtes-vous français? Oui, nous sommes français. Or, ou, Non, nous ne sommes pas français. Voilà, you can play with those two verbs to try to repeat again and again the sentences and it will come up easily. Don't worry about it. Très bien, très très bien. Donc, être et avoir, c'est très important de connaître et de savoir conjuguer être et avoir. C'est the basics of the basics. It's a must.